hello, Rebel, and welcome back to my life. I did get a new chair for Christmas. Thanks for noticing. Fun fact, if you see a Writer Wednesday video in 2 weeks that says the same thing, it's because I filmed that video this week, but it's private, but it'll be public in 2 weeks. My brain decided to start having thoughts about freelancing, what it is, how it exists, what's best to do when you're freelancing in this world. And when the brain just starts running like that, I'm trying to get much better about going into the office, turning on the camera, and just talking. So here's like the already commonly known, over-talked about aspect of freelancing, is that it seems like a way to have a lot more personal freedom in your life, but it usually doesn't turn out to be the case. Because there is the working aspect of freelancing, which yes, you do have a little bit more personal freedom with that because you can set your own work schedule as long as you get your job done by the client's deadline. But then there is the getting work aspect of freelancing, and that is just, it's just the worst. In my past as a freelancer and in my present as an indie author, I spend 60% of my time and 99.9% of my stress on drumming up new business, not doing the work. So why would anybody opt into this lifestyle? Why would anybody choose freelancing? Everybody's answer to that is going to be different, but for me personally, it is because I would rather choose the stress and the danger, honestly, that I know and am somewhat in control of over the stress and the danger that I am not in control of at all. The first job I lost because I made a computer error that cost the company a lot of money. Okay, that's my mistake, right? That's obviously a thing that I did that caused me to lose my job. Except that here's the thing, I knew that this computer error could happen and that there was a simple fix that could be done in the computer program that would prevent it from ever happening, that would prevent it from ever being an issue and ever losing the company money. It was a tiny little change that needed to be made that one person who was not me could make very, very quickly. But that person, interestingly, was a freelance computer programmer, and my boss and my boss's bosses did not want to pay that person to make the change in the computer program that I recommended that would have prevented the error from ever happening in the first place. I'm not in control of that. I could not have been in control of that. I tried very hard, but in the end, it just wasn't up to me. And so when you freelance, I believe that you are trading the insecurities of I could be fired at any time for circumstances completely beyond my control for the insecurity of I might have difficulty drumming up new clients, but I am never going to lose my job. There is another aspect of freelancing, and this is really what my brain started turning on this morning and what made me sit down and turn on the camera and just start riffing. Because the most important, absolutely the single most important aspect of any sort of independent career, whether as a freelancer or as an independent creator, is choosing your clients. Because broadly, generally speaking, you can sell to one of two types of people. You can sell to an audience, or you can sell to other businesses. And my freelance work before I took off as an indie author was selling to other businesses. I was selling editing and formatting services for other indie authors to help them get their books published. But here's the problem. A lot of people publish their first independent novel and then quit. That's the thing. Businesses are flighty because businesses are people. Not in that shitty Citizens United kind of a way, but in the way that they are made up of people. People who make decisions based on the fact that they are human beings. So then we come to indie authordom, or really any sort of independent creative field. Me, writing books for you, my readers. From a business standpoint, when I have 100,000 people around the world who have read my books and enjoyed them, that is so much more stability than I have ever had in my life. And it is true that as an indie author, I'm not in control of everyone out there. I'm not in control of the individual people who buy and read and review and tell their friends about my books, all of which are very helpful, by the way, and you should go do all of them. Have I mentioned I write books? Working for a company or working with freelance clients, the number of people who have to decide not to work with you for whatever reason is very, very small. In order to kill or seriously harm my work, the amount of people who would have to abruptly and out of nowhere stop reading fantasy novels is so high that it's just really not something I have to worry about. And my takeaway from it and from all the brain spinning that's been going on this morning is two things. One, the more people you work with and have a business relationship with, the more secure you are because the more people have to abruptly decide to stop working with you and you can be much more in control of that number of business interactions as opposed to a very small number of business interactions. And number two, because there will always be those people who are freelancing or doing whatever it is that they do where they are in a business relationship with a relatively small number of people. If that is your situation, recognize that insecurity and charge what you are worth. I know that advice can be hard to implement. Trust me, I know we always have to start off charging less than we're actually worth, but you should graduate yourself as fast as you possibly can to not just working for your daily or weekly or yearly survival, but working for your security. It's a really hard lifestyle. I wouldn't trade it for the world, but it is difficult. It is stressful. It has given me a lot of gray hair. And while it is terrifying, especially at the beginning, I'm glad to see a world developing where more and more of us are working not for ourselves, but for each other. And that's one of those things that sounds so cheesy that I just recorded it like 10 times in a row and I kept qualifying it and I kept making faces to be like, oh, but that's cheesy, right? It might be cheesy, but it's true. I hope that wherever you are on the work spectrum, Rebel, you are able to work on making yourself more and more secure. Because you deserve to be. And that is all I've got for you today, Rebel. This video, like all videos on my channel, is ad-free, and that is thanks to my wonderful supporters on Patreon. If you want to be one of those awesome and incredibly attractive individuals, check out the Patreon link in the description below. Thank you so much for watching. Holy shit, this is the last video of 2018. I hope you had a good year, and I will see you in the next one. Bye!